Believe the work of the Lord. If you are believing, you can see the glory of the Lord. In the Bible, there is a character. Book of Mark, chapter 2. There is a powerless person in this Bible, we can see. That powerless person believed. God bless you. You want to pray? That Jesus Christ can able to heal my body. What he was believing, our God was granting to him. Four people, they brought a powerless person in front of Jesus Christ. The nature of Jesus Christ is, he is a merciful God. The nature of Jesus Christ is, he is having compassion to each one of you, the people are walking here. The nature of Jesus Christ is, he is a loving kindness. Loving kindness is a nature of our Lord. Book of Mark chapter 2, where this one moment when we are reading the Bible, four people brought a powerless person in front of Jesus Christ. Powerless person, that means he is in sick. Come on. He is a sick person. He was a sick person. The people which they brought that powerless person in front of Jesus Christ, they were having the faith in God. Because of this reason,
I would show for at least maybe 2-3 months.
Bible says, Book of Mark. Chapter 2, where this one onwards, these four people could not reach to Jesus Christ because lots of crowds, lots of multitudes, they were standing, they were surrounded of Jesus Christ. Bible says, since they could not get to him, because of the crowd, they made an opening in the roof above Jesus by digging through it and then lowered. Praise the Lord. Lowered the mat the man was lying on. When Jesus saw their faith, Bible says, when Jesus saw their faith, that means each and every people is a miracle. If our God was doing, want to do any other miracle in your life? Come on. Can I pray for you 1 minute? Come. What's your name? Can I lay my hand on her? Heavenly Father, I pray for sister Mimi right now. I pray for sister, brother, sister right now, Father. Bless her spiritually and physically and all the areas. Any kind of sickness, call right now. By your stripes, sister already healed. I bless the sister. In Jesus' name, Shittatakaladi. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. God bless you. Okay, God bless you. Thank you. You want to pray? Everybody come over. I can pray for you. Your sister also. All the brothers, okay. This is a time, it's a healing time, okay. Never be, don't be ashamed, okay. This is a healing place. Come, I can pray for you. Come in. How are you? Nice to see you. Can I pray for you? What's your name?
Karen.
Come in, study. I pray for Brother Karen right now. Heavenly Father, I bless Brother. First of all, when I'm praying, I declare, brother, to get a home. Praise the Lord. To get a home, family. I pray for everything. Thank you for your adding everything, brother life. First of all, I want to pray for this brother to receive that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior.
Ready, I said Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior.
Yeah, yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Heavenly Father, I bless this brother. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Okay, thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. So that, God bless you. Come here, come right here. I'm calling everybody, okay? This is a healing time. Where I'm preaching, the healing power of the Lord, it is moving to each one of us. I know only one thing. When I am preaching this gospel, the power of the Lord, praise the Lord, the healing power of the Lord, it is moving from place to place, from people to people, from person to person. Only one thing. Jesus Christ is a healer. Come on. Come, come on. I'm calling you. Praise the Lord. Thank you very much. I will call everybody, each and every people. God bless. Come in. I'm calling you. At least you are hearing word of God. That's very important one. Amen. Faith is coming by hearing this word of God. Praise the Lord. This is what? Book of Mark, chapter 2, verses 1 onwards. That four people uncovered, praise the Lord, uncovered the roof of the house. They brought that powerless person down to in front of Jesus Christ. Then what happened? Jesus Christ has seen their faith. Who is faith? The people which they have brought that powerless person in front of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ has seen their faith. That means all these four people, come on, God bless you. Give to somebody. If you are born again, give to somebody. Sorry? God bless you. Jesus Christ has seen their faith. Come on. Because of this reason, Jesus Christ said to the powerless person, praise the Lord, your sins are forgiven. One more thing I want to say to each one of you. Why this powerless person could not receive the healing in his life? Because he was a sinful person. He was living under the sinful life. The purpose of manifestation of Jesus Christ in this world. Not only to take over your sins from you, but to get everybody a healthy body. Got it? To get everybody a healthy body. Got it? So today, all the ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters in Jesus, if our God want to heal you in your body, if he want to receive the healing in your body, one thing, the first of all, our God is asking to each one of you, praise the Lord, you have to repent your sins.
Yes, Jesus. Sound good, yeah? Huh?
You want to pray? I can pray for 1 minute. Come here, I can pray for you.
Huh?
I can pray for you 1 minute. If you want. God bless you. At least you are taking that. Read that right. Thank you. Praise the Lord. So that people are watching only one thing today, the day, the time, the moment, when you are repenting your sins, the next level from the Lord, what you are going to get, you are getting the healing, you are getting the deliverance, you are getting eternal life. Bible says, those who are in Christ Jesus, you are the new creation. You are created. New only for Christ Jesus to spread the gospel to everybody. Come on. All the ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. God bless you, okay. Read this yourself, okay. Give your brother. Thank you very much. So today, I want to ask whether you want to receive eternal life or you want to help, it's up to you. That the life our God has kept you. Before, come on, your brother. Come on. That the life our God has kept before you. If you want, you can receive life. If you want life, you have to accept this powerful God. You shall not accept. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So that whenever I'm preaching, I'm so much enjoying your preaching gospel because this God has saved my life. I was a broken hearted person. rejected person. I was in the point of the death, 2013. But in that year, when I came to know Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ has changed my life. I got a better life. All my sorrows, all my depressions, all my anxieties, our God has taken away from me.